Hello students, in last lecture we discussed about the if S and T are the two subspaces of the vector space V or the two linear transformations from the V to W, then we define the operation S plus T and S into T on the any element V belongs to V. Okay, in last lecture we discussed about some of the linear transformation. So here sum of the linear transformation and the product of the linear transformation. So how the sum of the linear transformation is defined? Here the sum, if S and T are the any two linear transformations from the V to W, then S plus T is again a linear transformation from the V to W, and which can be defined as S plus T operating on the any element V belongs to V, such that S plus T operating on V is equal to S of V plus T of V. This is again a linear transformation from the V to W. And what is the second product of a linear transformation? So in the product, what we have here discussed, so if M and P are the vector spaces over the field F, if we have n three vector spaces given, such that S is linear transformation from M to N, T is a linear transformation from the N to P, then we define the product of this linear transformation as an TS. TS, where TS is a linear transformation from the M to P, such that it is defined by TS operating on M, where M is an element belongs to M, which is equal to T in bracket S into operating on the M, which is again a mapping from the M to P and which is a linear transformation. So sum of the linear transformations and the product of the linear transformation is again a linear transformation. Now we discuss about the sum theorem, which is based on this sum and the product of the linear transformation. Now the statement of the theorem is, let V and W be the vector space over the field F, and let LVW denote the set of all linear transformations from V into W, then LVW is a vector space over the field F with respect to operation. Two operations are defined, S plus T, for ST belongs to LVW, and alpha S, where alpha belongs to field F and the S belongs to linear transformation or set of linear transformation from V to W. Okay, so first of all, we have given as V and W are the two vector spaces, and this is important notation, LVW. What stands for? It denotes the set of all linear transformations from the V to W. This is the set which is consisting of the linear transformations, all linear transformations from the V to W. Okay, then what we have to show? We have to show that LVW is a vector space over the field F. Then we have to show that this set of linear transformations, LVW, is a vector space over the field F, and with respect to operation, two operations are defined, S plus T, for ST belongs to LVW, and the alpha S, for alpha belongs to field F, and the S is a linear transformation from the V to W. Therefore, with respect to these two binary operations, we have to show that this LVW is a vector space. So, proof. Now, as we have to show that LVW is a vector space with respect to this binary operation S plus T and alpha of S. For this, we have to show that first of all, we have to show that S plus T belongs to LVW and alpha S belongs to LVW. So, for how will we can show that S plus T belongs to LVW? For this, what we have to show? S plus T is again a linear transformation from the V to W. Why this? Because LVW is a set of linear transformations from the V to W. Therefore, for showing S plus T is a member of and this LVW set, we have to show that this again a linear transformation from the V to W. Similarly, for showing alpha S belongs to LVW, we have to show that alpha S is a linear transformation from the V to W. So what is an properties for showing a linear transformation? We have to show the two properties for showing the linear transformation. Which are this property? For showing the linear transformation, we have to show these two properties. T operating on V1 plus V2 is equal to TV1 plus TV2 for any V belongs to V, and T of alpha V is equal to alpha TV for alpha belongs to field F and the V belongs to V, where T is a map from the V to W. These properties, these two properties are satisfied by this T, which is a map from V to W. Then this T is a linear transformation from the V to W. Therefore, for showing S plus T and the alpha S are again linear transformation from the V to W, we have to show these two properties are satisfied by the S plus T and the alpha of S. Therefore, so first we check that S plus T and alpha S actually belongs to LVW. We have to show that this S plus T alpha S belongs to LVW. Now let V1 and V2 belongs to vector space V. For showing this S plus T belongs to LVW, we have to show that these two properties are satisfied by the S plus T, which are the properties of linear transformation. For this, we consider the two members belongs to V1 and V2. Then the first property, what we have to show? S plus T operating on the V1 plus V2 is equal to, we have to show S plus T V1 plus S plus T into V2. So, now how it can be written, which is equal to, then multiply S and T separately to V1 to V2, which is equal to S V1 plus V2 plus T V1 plus V2. Now, which is equal to, again S should be multiplied inside the bracket and T multiplied inside the bracket, which is equal to S of V1 plus S of V2, and in second bracket T of V1 plus T of V2. Now, which is equal to, how it can be written? It can be written as S of V1 plus, take terms of an V1 together, S of V1 plus T of V1 in one bracket and terms of V2 in the second bracket. S of V2 plus T of V2. Now, here the V1 is common in the first bracket, okay, so V1 take out common, therefore it can be written as an S plus T operating on V1 plus S plus T operating on the V2. Okay, that's we have to show. For showing the first property of a linear transformation, we have S plus T operating on V1 plus V2 is equal to S plus T operating on V1 and S plus T operating on the V2. Therefore, the first property for the linear transformation is satisfied. Okay, so for showing the second property, so what is the second property now? For the second property, what we have to show? We have to show that for any, let consider for any zeta belongs to F. Zeta, this is a notation for the zeta, and you consider as a scalar which is belongs to field F. We have consider S plus T operating on the zeta of V. Okay, so for showing the second property, consider as zeta and multiply to the any vector V belongs to V. Therefore, which is equal to, what is this is equal to, then multiply S and T separately to zeta of V, which is equal to S into zeta of V plus T into zeta of V. Therefore, take zeta outside the bracket, which is zeta into S of V plus zeta into T of V. Now, as zeta is common in the both terms, therefore take a zeta common, therefore which is equal to zeta into in bracket S of V plus T of V, which is equal to, here V is common in both brackets, therefore take a V as a common from that, which is equal to zeta into in bracket S plus T and operating on the V. Okay, so we get what we have to show. Therefore, we have S plus T operating on the zeta of V is equal to zeta into s plus t operating on the V. Therefore, both the properties of a linear transformation are satisfied by the s plus t, as s plus t v1 plus v2 is equal to s plus t v1 plus s plus t v2, and s plus t into zeta of v is equal to zeta into s plus t operating on the V. Therefore, suppose this is first and the second. Therefore, from first and second, S plus T belongs to LVW. S plus T belongs to LVW means what? That is, S plus T is a linear transformation from the V to W. That's we have to show. We have to show that S plus T belongs to LVW. That is, we have to show that S plus T is a linear transformation from the V to W. Therefore, the first here first property is satisfied. Now what we have to show? We have to show that in the second case, what we have to show? Alpha of S is also belongs to LVW. Therefore, by showing such a properties, such a two properties, we can also show that alpha of S is also belongs to LVW. Now consider the second case or the second property. Now we have to show that alpha of S belongs to that set. Okay, so turn it into mapping. Alpha of S, we have alpha of S operating on V1 plus V2 is equal to alpha of S operating on the V1 plus V2. How it can be written? Take alpha outside and consider S inside to bracket S into V1 plus V2. Then multiplied S to V1 and V2, which is alpha into S of V1 plus S of V2. Then, which is equal to, then multiplied alpha inside the bracket to both the terms, which is alpha into S of V1 plus alpha into S of V2. Therefore, by using this condition, we have, which is nothing but, which is equal to alpha S into V1 plus alpha S into V2. Therefore, the first property is satisfied by the alpha S into V1 plus V2 is equal to alpha S V1 plus alpha S V2. Now, for the second property, consider alpha S into zeta of V. What we have to show? Which is equal to zeta into alpha S V. Therefore, which is equal to alpha into S of zeta of V. Therefore, which is equal to alpha into, take a zeta outside the bracket, zeta into S of operating on the V, which is equal to, take a zeta outside the bracket, alpha into zeta in one bracket into S of V, which is equal to, which can be written as alpha and zeta are the both members over the field F, and over the field F commutativity property holds. Okay, so therefore it can be written, alpha zeta can be written as an zeta alpha. Okay, since commutativity property holds in the field F, which is can be written as an zeta into alpha into S of V. Therefore, which is equal to zeta into alpha S operating on the V. Why this happens? Since F satisfies the commutative law for multiplication. Okay, so both the properties of an linear transformation are satisfied by the alpha of S from this third, suppose this equation third and this is equation fourth. Okay, so from third and fourth, alpha S belongs to LVW. Therefore, the both properties are satisfied by the alpha S and the S plus T. implies that these are the belongs to LVW. Now we have what we have to show. We have to show that this LVW is a vector space. Okay, so we have to show the properties of the vector space for the LVW. So for showing the vector space, what we have to show? We have to show that the zero element belongs to that set. The inverse of every element is belongs to that set. Okay, so these are the properties for showing and vector spaces. Now, as U belongs to V into a zero vector, as U belongs to V into a zero vector satisfies the condition that T plus zero is equal to T. We know that for the any linear transformation T which is belongs to LVW, if we consider the addition of an linear transformation with the zero linear transformation, their addition is again an T. Okay, the transformation which is an itself. Therefore, there exists an zero vector or the zero linear transformation in the LVW. Okay, therefore this property of an existence of an zero vector is satisfied in the LVW, and also and the transformation minus of T defined by minus of TV is equal to minus of TV, and also the linear transformation minus T is belongs to LVW, such that minus TV is equal to minus of T operating on V, which satisfies T plus minus of T is equal to zero, such that the inverse of the every element is exist in the LVW. That is for the linear transformation. For any linear transformation T, there exists a minus T belongs to LVW, such that T plus minus of T is equal to zero. Therefore, these two important properties are satisfied by the LVW. There exists a zero element, which is nothing but the zero transformation, such that T plus zero is equal to T, and there exists an inverse transformation minus of T for the every T belongs to LVW, such that T plus minus of T, which is equal to zero transformation, which is equal to zero. Therefore, these two important properties are satisfied by the LVW, and we can obviously shown that shows the other properties are also satisfied in the LVW. And easily observed that all other properties vector space is satisfied by LVW. Hence, LVW is a vector space. So all the properties of vector spaces is satisfied by the LVW, and therefore LVW is a vector space. Therefore, hence there is a proof of this theorem.